Hi there to everyone watching and welcome back to my channel. My name is Terry and this is my Eurovision reaction and review channel. And this video is reacting to the news that we received on Saturday evening. The shock surprise news, I guess you could say, about the United Kingdom and that Olly Alexander will be representing them in Eurovision 2024. And as a British person, this is news that is extra important and special for me. So this video will probably be a little bit longer and more detailed than some of my other internal selected artist reviews, reactions that I've been doing. So in this video, I'm just going to be checking out the announcement story on Eurovision.tv to go through that and give everyone and myself a bit of a further understanding of him as an artist and as a person. Check out two of his previously released music videos and also just talking about my thoughts on it and how I think the UK could potentially do at Eurovision in 2024. So before we get onto that, please do consider liking this video if you do enjoy it, and please also consider subscribing and hitting the notification bell for all future videos coming out. It is this week the Albanian national selection and I will be uploading videos reacting to that, so if that sounds interesting to you, please do consider subscribing and hitting the notification bell. Please do also follow me on Instagram where I post my upload schedules each week and other Eurovision related news. There will also be timestamps in the description and down below for you to jump ahead to particular points in the video. So yeah, please like, subscribe, notification bell, Instagram, comment as well your thoughts on Olly Alexander as the UK announcement. I want to hear all of your thoughts and it's great to hear your contributions and opinions and everything like that. But without further ado, let's begin. Okay, so I've got up here the Eurovision.tv announcement of Olly Alexander being the UK representative at Eurovision. And let's just going to quickly go through the article, what they say, and then I'm going to give you some of my opinions about, well, no, I'll do the article, then we'll watch the videos, and then I'll do my opinions all at the end. So, multi-award-winning artist Olly Alexander represent the United Kingdom at the 66th Eurovision Song Contest in Malmo, Sweden. Sprung the surprise news during the grand final of BBC One Strictly Come Dancing to a delighted studio audience and millions of viewers watching across the United Kingdom. So this is quite important because Strictly Come Dancing is the most successful show on TV in the UK, one of the most watched TV shows on the BBC outside of Eurovision. On BBC, they're probably the two biggest, most watched shows. I think on the final, it's getting around 8-9 million viewers. That's a lot of people to be watching to receive this news, and it does show a determination from the BBC that they now are taking Eurovision as a very serious contest, whereas before it was probably seen as something, you know, that they just do each year just because they feel like they have to do it, you know. But now it feels like it's part of their DNA in a way and something that they want to do well at each year. So that's really great news from a British fan perspective. And we've got this quote here from Olly. He's saying that he loved watching Eurovision every year, ever since I was a little kid, beyond excited to be taking part. Young boy always looked forward to this incredible event of unbridled joy, wonderful chaotic mix of musical styles, theatrical performances, heartfelt emotion and humour. Can't believe I'm going to be part of such a special legacy and fly the flag for the UK. In the gayest way possible, it shall be an honour. I've wanted to do this for a long time and it felt like the right moment to start releasing music under my own name. Determined to give it everything I've got and put on an excellent and unforgettable performance for you all. So obviously quite a lot of times people will take part in the contest, say that how much of a bigger fan they are. You know, it's always great when they do that, but I do feel that it is particularly true in this case. And also it's important because he's trying to do stuff underneath his own name and not using the years and years name, which obviously he has been using for since the beginning of his musical career. So obviously it's something that he's taking very seriously, so we can be sure that the song's going to be a great song, he's going to put on a great performance, he's going to be very dedicated and motivated to doing well. So those are all very strong things that I'm very excited about. And about Olly Alexander, so as he embarks on his first release under his own name, Olly Alexander remains one of the world's most trailblazing modern pop stars. Across across three hugely successful albums to date, the singer, actor and fashion icon secured two number one UK albums, 10 top four singles, and recently awarded Brit Billion Awards with 6.5 billion streams globally. So yes, he's a very big name, very successful in Europe, known to a lot of people. And it's the first time, probably having to go all the way back to Cliff Richard in the 60s and 70s, that the UK has sent someone with as much modern, recent success in the music industry. And of course, as we said, he's an actor as well, so he's got success in other industries too, in the entertainment sphere. So coming down a bit more, years and years evolving into a solo project, and in 2024, a brand new solo era, Olly has become once in a generation voice. TV show It's a Sin, Best New Drama, also nominated for Leading Actor at the BAFTA Television Awards. So I'm hoping that he can bring in his acting skills into his performance. We do know that he is able to put on a great stage performance. So really looking forward to see what he brings on that side of things, because I think in Eurovision nowadays, you need to bring both a song, but also be able to capture people with your personality and stage presence. Having headlined arenas and festivals worldwide, not to mention collaborating with the likes of Sir Elton John, Kylie and Pet Shop Boys, his icon status recently saw him immortalised at Madame Tussauds, fitting home for a pop star who has helped change British culture forever, now representing the United Kingdom at the Eurovision Song Contest. And his UK entry co-written by Danny L. Hall will be revealed in due course. And I mean, I'm not too up with modern music scene, but I do know, and I have heard that Danny L. Hall is a very up-and-coming modern music producer who's writing a lot of hits for very successful people. So altogether, this does sound like a very professional, top-quality procedure, and it will be very interesting to see what they come up with. So yeah, that is just a little bit about his history. So what I'm going to do now is listen to two of his previously released music videos, and then after that give you my overall opinions. So let's begin. So I've gone with two recent videos and song releases, both from 2021. And as I said, I'm not really too much up into the modern music scene and all that kind of thing. So I haven't actually heard, to the best of my knowledge, these two songs. It will actually be a first time reaction for me, surprisingly enough, since I am British. But let's have a little listen and see what I actually think. So first up, we've got here Starstruck. So let's begin. And of course, I do know that his musical sound is sort of very electro pop style. Nice, it's kind of a bit of like a 80s-ish vibe there. Really kind of getting the personality acting, personality coming through there. Yeah, really sort of giving like a fun disco-y dancey vibe. And yeah, I think as you can tell here very clearly, he's able to bring a good personality. So really interesting to see what he can do with a live performance, as I said. I really am liking kind of the production in the song. It's got that kind of nice summery fun vibe. And obviously it's something that, you know, can get the audience and the arena really enthralled, if he is to go for something similar to this. Which from everything I've heard, sounds like it will be something quite upbeat and fun. Thank you. And I definitely feel that we're getting the impression that we're getting something very modern. Perhaps something the most, well, we've had modern the last couple of entries from the UK, but perhaps something that's more in the fun, up-tempo vein. And from an artist that's obviously very modern too. Something a little bit different from what we've been sending recently too. So the second of the songs I'm checking out is Sweet Talker, which I can actually see is 3 minutes long. So it will be very interesting to see how he manages to do with a song that is compressed to 3 minutes, like his actual Eurovision entry would be. So let's check it out. Okay, so getting something perhaps less poppy fun and a bit more kind of clubby in style here. Yeah, it's got a really nice modern sound coming through. It'd be very interesting to see what kind of costume outfit he comes to go with, because I do know that he has got this very androgynous look with like his music videos and his personality and just in general life. And I am really liking these vocals here in the videos. I have heard that sometimes these live vocals can be a bit hit or miss. But I have also heard that he has got stronger in that sense in recent years. And I'm sure hopefully with a lot of time to perfect it all, those can be worked on. And also, I think because he's a quite an established artist with a established records company, and he's obviously very... dedicated to try and push himself as an individual artist in his own name, that all these things will be worked on. I'm sure there'll be a lot of focus on perfecting everything. Yeah, these music videos are very interesting. There's very sort of filmatic in a way. So I'm very interested to see what he brings as a stage performance, because as I said, I feel like everything as an old package is going to be very well taken into account. But yeah, there we go. That's my reaction to both of those songs. Okay, so there we have it. I've reacted to two of his previously released music videos from 2021. As I said, it is a very big new step for the UK in Eurovision. Going for someone that has had such recent success is quite a big, well-known name, both in the UK and also in Europe. I mean, someone that has got lots of strings to his bow, so to speak, with his music career, but also now into into his acting career, so I feel like he could bring both of those together to create a good stage presence, stage performance. As you've seen in recent years, you know, you need to be able to give a good performance as well as just having a good song. You know, with this, just this recent year, we've got Tattoo, Cha Cha Cha, you know, Unicorn, all of them kind of gave more than just the song. They all had a performance around them. And I feel like he is able to bring that kind of thing to get to Eurovision. And I feel like he's the sort of person that I want to have quite a lot of control over what goes on in terms of the song and the stage performance. So I feel like that is always very important, because I think now in Eurovision, we're moving to a time whereby the songs that do well are not songs that are just written for somebody and they go on stage and they perform it and they do all the dance moves or whatever that someone else has told them to do. I feel like the songs that are starting to get successful are the ones where the artists themselves are having quite a big say and control over what's going on. So it makes me feel very optimistic for the UK's chances next year. I have seen a lot of optimism from across Europe as well. That makes me very excited. As a UK fan, obviously, there were a lot of very bad years. You know, since 2000, there's only been a handful of results that have got us, you know, a respectable result. But I feel like this year, 2023 with May, it was a little bit of a blip. But I think since Sam riding 2022 in particular, things have got a lot better. I feel like the double zero in 2021 with James Newman with Embers, whilst very embarrassing result, I think it was that wake up call for the BBC that they needed to realise actually other countries are taking this very seriously, and we're this the biggest broadcaster in Europe, and we're coming bottom with 0 points, and these other broadcasters are probably laughing at us and thinking how terrible we are. So I feel like it was the wake-up call. They need to start taking things seriously, and I feel since Sam in 2022, there's been such a big turnaround in public perception. I feel like the public perception even before that was starting to turn around, and they were realizing that the results were because of bad songs rather than the perceived everybody 18 the UK narrative that was pushed before. But I feel now there is just a general widespread belief and view of Eurovision that is in a much more positive position than it was just a few years ago. So yeah, overall really excited about this news, really excited to see what is going to bring. Really happy that we've actually had such an early release, because normally with the BBC, we're only finding out the news sort of late February, early March, and it's just like a long list and sort of line of names and rumours and all that kind of thing up to that. So I'm very happy that we've got this news so early too, so a performance can be perfected. The song, I think, is probably already constructed, but you know, everything else around it can be perfected. Hopefully there'll be some promotion. It's been revealed so early, so he can go around Europe and promote it. I think he would want to do that anyway, because he wants to kind of start his own career out on his own name. So I'm sure he's going to promote it out to Europe anyway, and his record company will support him with that. So similar to Sam Ryder in 2022, which we didn't get with May this year in 2023, really. So I feel like we'll have a lot more like Sam in 2022, and I feel like a result similar to that is really achievable too. So really excited about all of that. But yeah, those are most of my opinions. So please do let me know down in the comments below what you think. Are you a fellow Brit, and how excited are you about this news? And just, yeah, if you're from anywhere in Europe or the world, please let me know what you think about this. I'd be very interested to hear what you say, especially as I said, the UK is my own country. So please do let me know all that down below. Please like this video if you enjoyed it. Please consider subscribing and hit the notification bell to be informed of all future Eurovision releases. And please do follow me on Instagram if you want to see my upload schedules for each week and other Eurovision related news. And yeah, I think that's everything. I can't think of anything else to say. I probably am forgetting something, but can't think of it at the moment. So I hope you did enjoy this video. If you did, please do. Oh, even if you didn't, please do take care. And until the next video, take care and goodbye.